Developing assessment instruments for endorsement. Chapter 2, Using the Endorsement Application. As mentioned in Chapter 1, this presentation is recorded in three chapters. Chapter 1 covered the pre-reading, familiarisation with QCAA resources, and reflection on previously developed assessment instruments that is recommended before you begin to develop assessment instruments for a new cohort of students. This chapter explains how to access and use the assessment templates, as well as the features of the endorsement application that help you to quality assure your assessment instruments before you submit them for endorsement. Chapter 3 will outline where you can find additional support and information when developing your assessment instrument and as it progresses through the endorsement process. Using the endorsement application, accessing and navigating assessment templates. There are three levels of access in the endorsement application. These are used to help schools manage the development and approval of assessment instruments before they are submitted to the QCAA for endorsement. During this presentation, and as shown here, the endorsement workflow for schools is used to step through the process of editing, approving, and submitting an assessment instrument. To access the assessment templates, users must first be given access to their subjects and role in the endorsement application. This access is determined by the school and granted by the submitter. If you don't have the access you require and you are unsure who your school submitter is, ask a colleague with access to the endorsement application to click on the submitters link in the ribbon at the top of the screen to display the list of submitters for your school. Submitters can allocate you the required access in the endorsement application. Once you have been granted an editor, approver, or submitter role, you can see past assessments or create a new assessment by selecting the appropriate exit year from the menu. Because some schools may implement an assessment instrument towards the close of Year 11 and others start in the final year of the course, we have organised assessment instruments in the endorsement application according to the year that students will exit the subject and complete the external examination. Once you have selected the exit year, the assessment instrument templates will be displayed based on the subjects that you have been allocated. The assessment instruments are organised by event, i.e. the timeline in which they must be submitted for endorsement. This matches the order for implementation and the confirmation process. If you believe the order is incorrect, please speak to your submitter. The submission timelines are indicated in the event information, shown here in blue. Assessment templates are color-coded based on their stage of development, and a key is provided to help you quickly recognize the stage of development. All assessment that has not been edited begins with the grey not started status. The status will update as you develop your assessment instrument and once each endorsement decision is published. An assessment instrument that is not endorsed at the close of application 1 reverts to not started to indicate that it requires revision. At intervention, the assessment instrument becomes locked. To open an assessment instrument template, click on the coloured bar for that assessment instrument. Once you have opened the assessment template, you will see a number of features designed to make collaboration between school users easier. The endorsement application allows multiple users to access the assessment template, but only one person can edit the assessment instrument at any time. The Contributors button allows you to see who can access this assessment template in your school. The Comments button allows you to communicate with other contributors during the development of your assessment. Use the comments to pose questions, identify issues to check, or provide instructions, such as where the files for attachments are located in your school drive. If your approver or submitter require further changes before they can progress your draft assessment instrument to the QCAA, they can also record instructions here. The comments do not print out on the assessment instrument, and neither the QCAA nor your students can see your comments. The endorsement application also includes information about the submission timelines for each application. This information updates as each application closes. The assessment status will also update as the assessment instrument is developed and approved. The assessment status section also provides access to send the assessment instrument to the approver or submitter once it is ready to be progressed. using the endorsement application, editing assessment questions. Now I'll talk you through the process of editing the assessment instrument in the template using the endorsement workflow. To start to create the assessment instrument, click on the green Edit button. If you've offered this subject before, you will see a pop-up on screen that asks if you'd like to copy across a previously endorsed assessment instrument when you first start to develop your assessment. If you want to start with a previous assessment instrument, select one from your version history, and the endorsement app will copy across the developed content to the new template. It will not copy across any attachments. You can copy across a previous assessment instrument and then edit as needed, or you might choose to start with a clean template. To develop the assessment instrument, there are three tabs for you to work in: Assessment, Attachments, and QA Tool and Decisions. Under the Assessment tab, you will see an accordion called Conditions. Clicking on the plus will expand the accordion. To reduce it, click on the minus. Most of the assessment conditions are pre-populated for you. However, your syllabus may require you to make a selection from the topics in that unit or the mode of the response. Please check this accordion to identify whether a selection is expected. If options are provided and you do not make a selection, you will not be able to submit the assessment instrument. All other information in the Conditions tab is directly drawn from the syllabus and cannot be edited. The next accordion is called Marking. The ISMG, or in the case of Essential English or Essential Maths, the Standards Matrix, is provided and can be opened and printed from here. You can't edit this document. It is already instrument specific. When you print your assessment instrument, the ISMG, or Standards Matrix, is included in the task sheet. If you just want to print the ISMG or the Standards Matrix on its own, you can download it from the Marking tab in the assessment template. The marking summary from your syllabus is also provided in the marking accordion. This will be printed on your assessment cover sheet. You will see that on the task sheet, a space is provided for you to record the result a student achieves for their response once it has been marked. When you go to print your task sheet from the endorsement app, if your ISMG or standards matrix doesn't fit the page properly, click on Print Preview. Then go to your printer settings and look for the option to Fit, Fit to Page, or Fit to Printable Area. This will resize the pages to fit an A4 page. You will not be able to change where page breaks occur in the ISMG. The third accordion is named after your assessment technique, so it might be called Composition, Extended Response, Investigation, Performance, or Project. The subsections for your assessment are accessed from this accordion. Guidance and examples are provided to guide you in developing your assessment. Fields marked with a red asterisk must be populated with information or the assessment instrument cannot be submitted. If it is for a field that does not require content and you leave it blank, then the heading for that section will not be printed on the task sheet. For example, if you don't have scaffolding, you can leave it blank and the scaffolding heading won't appear on the PDF. If it is an examination or data test, there will be a space for writing instructions to students in this accordion. When you're writing instructions for students about how and where to write their response, you should refer to the published confirmation submission guidelines, which can be found in the syllabus application. Short and combination response examinations are comprised of a number of items that students must respond to under supervised conditions within a defined period of time. In an examination or a data test, there is a fourth accordion called Questions, and this is where you construct the items for the examination. The information and rules built into this section are customized for your syllabus. It defines the number and type of items that the assessment instrument must contain to satisfy the assessment specifications for this technique. You can create more items than specified as you draft your examination. However, to submit it to your approver, you will need the examination to comply with any specifications defined by the syllabus. For example, In Accounting, IA1 and IA2, Part A, the syllabus specifies that 2 short response items are required. You can create more questions as you consider what could be assessed, but to submit the task to the approver, you must decide which 2 questions will be used. If you are working in a language's IA2 template, you will see that it is already divided into 2 sessions for you, so that you can develop and print separate papers for each examination session. These are treated like 2 separate examinations in the template, with their own conditions and ISMG, but together they comprise 1 assessment instrument when submitted for endorsement. To add items, click on the Add Element button. Options for question types that are allowed by the syllabus are shown here. In this case, only short response items can be selected. The app will automatically number each item, and it will also renumber the items if you move them or add or delete questions. You can also choose to include a space for general content. Any type of information can be added in this field, but it will not be numbered. A general content field might be used if you have a data set, image, graph, or table that is used to answer a number of questions. You would then add instructions to students to refer to that graph, diagram, data, etc. as they answer questions 1 to 3, for example. Once you've added a question or general content, you can use the up and down arrows in the top corner of the question content box to change the order of the items in relation to each other. The question numbering will automatically update to reflect the new order. For each question, you must also add question settings. This is where you might identify the marks for the question, the word length guide for students, and format a response space. Click on the Edit button to enter this information. The blue information icons will explain what is printed on the task sheet when you hover your mouse over an icon. You can also add an estimate of the time it would take to respond to an item. This does not appear on the task sheet, but it is provided as a self-check, so you can see an estimate of the total time to complete the exam and determine if the assessment instrument is of suitable scale, particularly in assessment templates that allow unlimited items. If you have a question with multiple parts, you can click on the plus icon at the end of the marks allocation row to add extra rows. To remove a row, click on the minus. Short and combination examinations have a new option in the Add Elements menu, which is a search through My Items. Selecting this option will let you search through items from your previously endorsed assessment instruments and approved comparable assessment instruments for this technique and unit of work. When you click on Search My Items, you will see filter options for narrowing the item types in your search. For some subjects, there may be no question categories due to the specifications of your syllabus. In this case, the question options are simple familiar, complex familiar, and complex unfamiliar questions. I can select 1, 2, or all categories to see my banked questions, or if I untick each question category, it will show only the general content items. If I select just the complex familiar items, the matches are shown here, with a brief description of the items to help me locate the one I'm looking for. If I click on one of the options provided, the preview pane shows me the question. If this is the question I want, I click on Insert this item and it is copied to the assessment template. I can then edit the item if I need to or keep it as it is. I might also change the marks for this item or the response space using the Edit button for the question settings. You can add items this way to a blank assessment instrument template or to an assessment instrument that was copied across from a previous year. The next video shows how to use the item search to insert a new item from a previously endorsed assessment instrument. Formatting options are accessed from the ribbon at the top of the item. These include bold, italics, and headings, which can be used to emphasize key information. The default font size is 12 point to cater for most students. Smaller font is not available. In languages, there are additional options in the font setting to give you access to the characters and letters of the language. Select the font to start writing questions in the template. If you have copied text from another source and are pasting it into the assessment template, ensure you highlight the text and select the app's font so the text converts to the font that is built into the app. If you do not do this, you will find blank sections in your printed task sheet. To add bullets, click one of the three ordered list formatting options: ordered list numeric, ordered list alphabet, or unordered list. If you need to add multi-level bullets, use the indent function. To go back to level 1 bullets, you need to add a line between consecutive sets of bulleted lists. In other words, your bulleted text, a blank line, hit enter and unbullet, and then a new line to start a new bulleted list. Enter, then click on bullets again. You can delete the blank line later. You can also type your text first, then highlight each section and apply the bullets as the last step. Leave a space between the lowest level of bullets and any new list. If your syllabus requires it, you will be provided with either a chemistry type equation editor or a mathematics type equation editor. These can be used to write equations and formulas using the inbuilt character types, or if you have a stylus, you can draw on the pad and it will convert into type text. To insert symbols into your questions, we recommend accessing symbols from the equation editor's special characters. Selecting special characters directly from the formatting options sometimes leads to a blank space instead of a character when the task sheet is printed. The equation editor does not present this problem. You can also format images, tables, symbols, and other functions in this application. If an image or data set doesn't fit within the space provided, consider developing it in another suitable program and including it as an attachment that will provide better legibility for your students. To manage the layout of the task sheet, you can also add page breaks from the formatting options. Short and combination response examinations also have an option to insert a page break after an item. You'll find that in their Add Elements menu. The page break could be used, for example, in a mathematics exam, to create two sections so that one paper could be implemented technology-free and the other group of questions could allow use of a calculator if you wanted to replicate the external examination format. The general content field can be used to make a text box for any headings or instructions. Help guides can be accessed from the Endorsement app by clicking the link at the top of the page. While you are working in the assessment template, the app will periodically save your work, approximately every 5 minutes. You should also save your assessment instrument at junctures, which will create a version history. This is because you can recall earlier saved versions of your assessment instrument if needed and make them the latest version. Before you exit the endorsement app, you must save a copy of your assessment instrument. Select the Save option, not the Save and Continue option. If you have not made any edits since the last time you clicked on Save, you won't be able to save again without adding a change of some sort. Adding a space somewhere or any other edit will allow you to save a new version. Saving is very important because if you don't save a new version and the next user rejects the offer to save changes when they open the assessment instrument, all changes will be lost and cannot be retrieved. This is not a Microsoft Word document. You cannot retrieve an unsaved copy. The Attachments tab includes a browser to allow you to attach stimulus, indicative responses, or marking schemes if they are required. For some assessment instruments, you will see that attachments are not possible or are optional. If attachments are mandatory, this will be outlined on screen. The requirements for any attachments are summarised in the help text. You should also refer to your syllabus and the published endorsement submission guidelines that are located in the resources section in the syllabus app. A range of file types can be added as attachments. Attachments are not automatically attached to your task sheet when you print it out. Items uploaded to the Attachments tab must be downloaded and provided to students when appropriate. This might include seen and unseen stimulus, audio-visual files, or documents that are printed to a larger paper size. Attachments might be provided to separate materials or can be printed and inserted to the task sheet in a convenient location. Other attachments, such as marking schemes or indicative responses, are not developed for student use but are required to support the endorsement process. Marking schemes can be replaced at any time, but all other attachments are locked once the assessment instrument is endorsed. If you upload a new marking scheme, please remember to delete the obsolete version. Using the endorsement application, quality assuring your assessment instrument. When you are close to completing the assessment writing phase for a short or combination response examination, you can use the endorsement app's check feature to check your items for compliance with the rules defined by the syllabus for this assessment technique. Just click on the blue check button in the questions accordion. For example, some subjects may specify the proportion of item types or require some items to elicit responses within particular word lengths. For extended response type assessment, you will not have a checker. But if you try to send your assessment instrument to your approver and it does not contain all expected attachments and have all the necessary fields completed, a warning will appear and the endorsement app will prevent progression of the assessment instrument until all requirements are met. For this mathematics examination template, unlimited items can be constructed, but the syllabus specifies the proportion of question types as a percentage. Warnings are provided to indicate compliance within the syllabus specifications. As you add or delete items, the checker will update to show whether the collection of items meets the assessment specifications. In this section, you will also see a table showing the distribution of marks. It updates on screen as you edit your questions. Then, once you have completed editing your assessment instrument, you can download a PDF of the mark summary to include with your marking scheme. Use this version of the marking summary to make sure the marks you awarded for each question in your examination match the mark allocations you are awarding on your solution and marking scheme. You will also see that there is now a space for you to record the student's mark for each question when you generate the print preview. This was added in response to school feedback. The third tab includes the quality assurance tool for this assessment instrument so that you can self-check your instrument. This is the list of criteria an endorser and lead endorser will use to review your assessment instrument to determine if it can be endorsed. Each of the assessment practices and priorities described in the quality assurance tool must be clearly demonstrated by the assessment instrument. After the endorsement meeting, this is also the place where you will see your endorsement decision. Decisions are published on the Friday of the week after the endorsement meeting. You will know when the decisions have been published because the colour of the assessment template will have changed from blue for submitted to either green for endorsed or grey, which indicates the assessment was not endorsed and the status has been reset to not started. If your assessment instrument is not endorsed, the directives that you need to action and contact details for the lead endorser will be displayed here. The print preview allows you to see the final product, make formatting decisions, and print your draft assessment instrument. You need to select dates from the calendar to generate a print preview. These can be updated as many times as needed, including after the assessment instrument is endorsed. Once the assessment instrument is endorsed, all other parts of the assessment instrument are locked to prevent further editing, and the draft watermark will be removed. Once you've checked the quality of the print preview and you are satisfied you have completed all of the checks, the assessment instrument can be progressed to the approver. If the assessment instrument is a short or combination response examination, you have the choice to include a space for recording the marks that a student achieved for their question. To add a space for marks on the task sheet, select the checkbox next to the prompt, Add a space to record marks. This will create a space in the question bar to write a mark. If you leave this unselected, the white space will not display. As this is part of the print preview menu, you can select and unselect this option as needed, even after the assessment instrument is endorsed. Using the endorsement application, approving and submitting your assessment instrument. Approving the assessment instrument. Once you have completed your quality assurance checks, you will be able to send your assessment instrument to your approver by clicking on the More Actions button in the status box and selecting Send to Approver. If your assessment is missing an expected attachment, such as a marking scheme, or if it doesn't meet requirements, such as the number of items, a warning will appear on screen and the assessment won't be able to be progressed to the approver. Click on the link in the warning message to see what actions are required. Once you have resolved any issues, you can send the assessment instrument to the approver. Approvers are expected to review the assessment instrument before they send it to the submitter. This includes proofreading for errors, including typos. As an editor, it can become difficult to see the typos when you have worked on an assessment instrument or to notice if you have inadvertently deleted a section of text. Approvers use the Quality Assurance tool in the Attachments tab to determine whether the assessment instrument provides evidence of all of the assessment practices and priorities. If the approver is not a subject matter expert, asking the editor to explain the choices and decisions can help the approver understand how the assessment instrument demonstrates the assessment specifications. If the approver identifies changes to be made before they progress it to the submitter, they can either make the changes themselves or return the assessment instrument to the editor to make the changes. The approver can add comments in the endorsement app to explain the required changes. These comments can only be seen by those people who have been assigned the editor, approver, and submitter roles for that assessment instrument. Submitting the assessment instrument. If the submitter determines that further actions are required, they can return an assessment instrument to the approver or editor. A pop-up comment box will appear so that comments or questions can be written for the editor or approver to action. If the submitter is satisfied with the assessment instrument, they can submit it to the QCAA for endorsement. Once the assessment instrument has been submitted, until the due date, a submitter can recall the assessment instrument if changes are required. Once recalled, the submitter can send the assessment instrument to the editor or approver to make the required changes. To resubmit the assessment instrument, it must go back through the Edit, Approve, Submit workflow. The QCAA also uses social media to share information about upcoming events, activities, and resources.